Subscribe to Zoom and click on the bell icon for the latest updates.
Yaar Mera Superstar.
वेलकम टू यार मेरा सुपरस्टार. मेरा नाम है संगीता एंड आज का जो शो है इट इज एक्सट्रीमली स्पेशल फॉर अस. इट इज द 50th एपिसोड ऑफ यार मेरा सुपरस्टार सीजन 2 एंड व्हाट बेटर. मतलब वी हैव टू अमेजिंगली टैलेंटेड पीपल. एक जो हमें मेसमराइज करते हैं विद दिस परफॉर्मेंसेज एंड द अदर पर्सन हुज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर सच अमेजिंग परफॉर्मेंसेज इट इज राजा मेनन एंड सैफ अली खान. वेलकम टू यार मेरा सुपरस्टार.
थैंक यू फॉर हैविंग अस.
But of course, Chef, it is the most talked about trailer. I have to tell you this. Okay. Like everybody is waiting to watch this movie.
Okay.
But coming to you first, Raja.
Yeah.
Chef, how did you decide that ye film jo hai, isko banana hai Hindi mein? Or when was the first time you ever saw the original?
I saw it when I was in the theater.
Okay.
Aur yaad hai ki nikalte I felt ki very rarely do I feel ki I should have made a film that somebody else has made.
Right.
So when I left it, I said, yaar ye to जोधपुर में तो विक्रम मल्होत्रा केम टू मी एंड सेड यार यू नो व्हाट डू यू थिंक ऑफ दिस फिल्म एंड आई सेड आई थिंक इट्स ग्रेट एंड देन ही सेड वुड यू मेक इट एंड आई सेड नो.
ओके फर्स्ट व्हाई वुड
यू या बिकॉज़ यू नो आई सेड इट्स अ गुड फिल्म इट्स ऑलरेडी बीन मेड इट्स लाइक अ रेसिपी फॉर फेलियर राइट व्हाई वुड आई डू इट एंड ही सेड थिंक अबाउट इट. And I started thinking about it because I really loved the film.
Mm.
And it had travel and food and the right. child and, you know,
And what an amazing combination, travel and food.
Isse zyada kya chahiye?
Correct.
So then we found a few angles between the writers and me, that Suresh and Ritesh and I. And that's when I said, okay, let's make it.
Let's do this. Saif, sabse zyada preparation iske liye kiya hai? Matlab literally in every sense, you know?
Nahi, preparation to ki bahut, you know, आज जो हम फिल्में बनाते हैं आई थिंक देयर इज अ डिफरेंट एक्सपेक्टेशन. एक रियलिज्म क्रिएट करने की कोशिश करते हैं तो हम चाहते हैं कि जो शेफ़ हो वो कंफर्टेबल लगे किचन में. तो रोज आई थिंक एक महीने के लिए डेढ़ महीने के लिए रोज़ाना 4 घंटे 5 घंटे प्रैक्टिस की. ज़्यादातर कटिंग की यू नो प्रीटी लेबोरियस काइंड ऑफ वर्क लाइक अनियन चॉपिंग And garlic chopping.
हम
नहीं चाहते थे कि हम चीट करें और राजा ने कह दिया था कि मैं ऐसा तो करूंगा नहीं कि एक प्रेवलेंट एटीट्यूड है हमारे यहाँ कि शायद क्लोजअप्स में संभाल लेंगे या किसी और के हाथ इस्तेमाल करेंगे और विच वी डोंट वॉन्ट. आई मीन यू नो तो हम तो लॉन्ग शॉट्स इस्तेमाल करेंगे. Wanted to look comfortable in a kitchen, so kafi preparation ki uske liye.
Listen, you're like, even you learned how to clean and
but
all,
I still
yeah?
say, you know, yes. cooking, cleaning, and yeah, I mean, everything. Chopping onions, high pressure woks with that high pressure flame, you know, for.
That's scary, quite scary when that flame is
sweaty,
on your face.
Sweaty, hot
yeah.
work, yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Right, right. And the body language, actually, you know, just being in the kitchen, ki, how do you feel comfortable as a chef? How do you interact with other people, how do you pick things up?
So of course you guys had a team who worked with you on this.
Some very, very helpful people, you know. Chef Himanshu comes to mind first of all, who from the Marriott, who he's moved now, I think, to the St. Regis. But
it's part of the same thing, yeah.
Yeah.
But so lots of them, we had a bunch of, that was one part of the training and I think we focused a lot on it in general.
Yeah.
We also spent a lot of time on just getting the character right.
But I think when you focus on anything, like the cooking, you kind of get committed to the movie in a way. So it's just an exercise really in various things. It's just like in relationship building between, you know, Raja and me to an extent and the other people that you're working with in the kitchen. I think that's what rehearsal really does, is create a kind of a comfort.
You know, we're very lucky to be in this business.
I'm sure, but you know, you're lucky. You got to travel, you got to eat.
Yeah,
and talking about travel, like New York, Amritsar, Kerala, which is like beautiful. So how did that journey work for you guys?
For me?
Yeah.
Well, it was the key of the film actually, because I think as much as we had recce'd it and, you know, researched it and everything else, I think what was most important, as we traveled through, we realized the diversity of the country. I mean, Kerala mein jo khana...
Koi aisi cheez jo pehle observe nahi kiya tha, aisa kuch hua during the journey?
Bahut kuch hai, matlab, forget about jo observe nahi kiya hai. Jab I've heard about Chandni Chowk and the food there, but I've never been much of that kind of manamek. I said, yaar, you know, chaat is chaat yaar. Like, what is there?
Jahan pe bhi khao chaat hai.
But you go there, uske baad kahin aur nahi khaoge aap.
Really? Maine nahi khaya.
Ja ke khaiye aap ek baar.
Wow.
Amritsar mein kulcha khana, it's a different thing, you know, the langar. It's
for me, Kochi was a revelation. I've traveled to most places that we've shot in before. But I don't think I'd been to Kochi before. And just the colors and the atmosphere and the people and how kind of laid back and kind of intelligent and, you know, politically smart and that they are. And their passion for food and just the colors of that place. And if you contrast that with a cold New York winter,
right,
the warmth of... And this hotel was amazing where I was put up.
Tell me, you had some amazing Kerala delicacies and all that. Puttu and
yes. Idiyappams, what?
Yep, idiyappam.
Yummy. Appam and stew.
Yep, and egg
roast. Great food, you know.
Yeah. Did you even make all of these dishes?
I made some of them and practiced some of them. But, I mean, food is there throughout the film like it is in our lives, you know. But it's not really a very food-heavy film. I mean, it sounds like it is. And we end up talking a lot about food. But it's a... take on modern relationships, you know. It's about a child of divorce. It's about divorce because not because of some affair or vamp or the way it's normally shown in movies, but bad time management or lack of, you know, priority, focus, this kind of urban issue.
Right.
When somebody's making money, sometimes they lose track of important things in life. So that was what I thought was exciting about the project. So food is a metaphor, but something that's going on.
It's the journey, it's the experience.
Glue.
So the van is something I want to own. Ye ek to BST bus hai, jo aapne bahut sari cheeze ki hai. So how was that?
We built it from scratch.
Yeah.
We built it, we bought a chassis and then built it like you build a set. So it's based on the what's called the Roadmaster, jo London mein jo bus, double decker buses jo hai. Uska design hai, basic design jo hai.
This is the Roadmaster.
It's called the Roadmaster, yeah. And we wanted something different. Food trucks to hai. Zyada nahi hai, but hai at least.
Haan, matlab wo normal wale hote hai na, aise normal bus dekhte hain, hum double decker wale food trucks maine nahi dekha hai.
It's a character in the film, you know.
Right.
And it's like, I mean, you've seen lots of films with vehicles, where some films like Chitty Chitty Bang Bang and Herbie Goes Bananas with talking cars or whatever.
Right.
But this is a symbol, it kind of, there's a... When I get the truck, it comes from a very unlikely source. And, you know, it's not something I'm happy about. It's not a great job for a chef to run a food truck, you know. But his friend tells him on the phone, because it's a khatara, you know, it's in a wreck shape. So he says, asli khatara to tum ho. You need to get your life organized, and this is a good opportunity. So transforming that truck from this wreck into the shining, gleaming Rasta Queen that it becomes, is also representative of what the kind of character goes through. It's symbolic of making the most of, like, a, you know, bad situation. And if you've got the talent, you can make something amazing out of it. So that's what it stands for.
Right. I think your wife was involved in this.
Very much.
Completely.
Yeah, she's a production designer.
Rock star, dude.
Yeah, she is a rock star.
She is.
And
it's
amazing.
Yeah.
Didn't her heart break when she was like, okay, then she was like, okay, then she was like,
and then she was like,
okay,
then
back kharab.
How many times did it happen? See your baby getting transformed.
It was a very interesting technique that she used, you know, where we didn't, where we created the nice truck and then aged it in a very interesting way so that your heart doesn't break.
Wow, listen, our heart is definitely not going to break. We love this movie already, but before we start with our next round, that's for you, sir.
Thank you.
And that's for you, Raja.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Okay, so we do something on the show which is called Kya Baat Hai. Okay?
What is this?
It is perfume.
Is it a candle? No, I thought it was...
No, you like the perfume. Yes, that's...
Thank you.
Okay, we do something on the show which is called Kya Baat Hai.
She expected us to come really sweaty.
I don't know, perfume is kind of girly, dude.
I know so many people who love collecting it.
Perfume.
No,
yeah.
Not aftershave.
And we normally give all homegrown brands which are all
lovely.
But this is feminine.
No, it's
not.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is there a gender to perfume?
It's called Bombay perfume.
I think perfume is girls and kind of aftershave is guys.
Okay. No, yeah. Nobody
cologne
nowadays.
Cologne is guys.
Cologne maybe.
Yeah, perfume.
Anyway, okay.
Anyway.
Let's continue with your...
We do something on the show called Kya Baat Hai. Okay, so I'll show photos. Dikhaungi. You have to tell me isme asal wali kya baat hai. Theek hai, story kya hai. Are you ready?
Okay.
Let's start with this one. Isme kya ho raha hai?
ये अभी गोवा से निकले हैं।
I think the three actors are saying where is the where's the director? कैमरा किधर है? हमको छोड़ दिया यहाँ पे as usual।
But एक गोवा में था।
ये गोवा में.
You want to hold this?
गोवा में. I know it's in Goa. Yeah.
It's outside Goa.
गोवा में था और this was an interesting place to shoot.
हाँ.
Because we were shooting it on a in an aerial shot.
हाँ.
और until the camera goes up, you don't realize कि पीछे क्या है.
हाँ.
So as the camera went up, we realized there were like 50 cars parked on the side.
Oh.
This was when the truck, the other truck broke down. It was very interesting. There was one truck going. We were waiting for the exact time.
हाँ.
5:55 को ऐसा कुछ shoot करना था. हाँ. Because sun was the right position. And this truck came down.
5:55 remembers the time.
Yeah, we were like,
dude.
We're a little okay. bit like, like that.
Yeah.
So there was a truck going down, and we said, okay, it'll pass by. And just as it gets exactly in front of our bus, it breaks down.
So all the planning, all the time.
Yeah, and we're like 5:55. There it goes.
Gosh, so, but yeah. it finally yeah, obviously fun, happened.
Yeah, and I think I was a little worried that they may actually fall off that.
Now you're telling them that.
I've done a bit of work before, so I asked him. I said, yeah, "Am like, I going to fall off this?" And he said, "No, no, no."
That,
but don't hold it high.
I said, "Don't put your weight on it."
Okay, this one so cute. I love this.
This is
yes.
It's like an awe photo.
Well, Swear, no. This yeah. is actually this is what moment. Why being a real father can be an advantage in playing these roles because you don't have to be too nice to your kids. In fact, it's never a good idea.
Really?
Yeah, too nice. Yeah, it's not realistic.
So
first
like
of all,
and
they don't
one?
Learn anything. Not strict, huh. but you have to have a bit of fun.
Yeah.
So he's obviously the vegetable carrier, and that's what children are for.
Yeah, that's right.
I thought it was always
for
the
chores.
Other way around.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, because we try and be too nice.
True.
So we make a nice realistic film about how to.
Train kids.
Yes.
Child labor.
Yes. Yeah. There's a wonderful vegetable store that we with Anu set up in Kerala.
Right.
Because the vegetable stores in Kerala are completely unique. Jo vegetables wahan jo dikhte hain kahin aur nahi dikhte.
Seriously? Like example? Haan,
pata nahi kya hai actually. This is strange vegetables.
Strange vegetables.
You can sense a certain pride
yeah,
and affinity.
It's like different.
I don't know why.
Just for that reason.
This is a tiny bit favoritism to the south.
No, it is,
to Kerala.
But unique, eh?
Honestly, I loved Kerala.
It's beautiful.
Kochi is one of the nicest cities I've ever been in.
Yeah, I've been to like Alappi, backwaters. It's stunning.
Yeah.
Okay. Very cute.
Where did that come from? What does that do with
Tell us, where
chef?
Is
Chef, it is a tasty picture. This is Gushtard.
Tasty picture.
This is Gushtard with a spread, with a
this
very happy
Temur's
looking
first,
Temur.
First holiday?
I think this
yeah.
is Temur's first holiday, yes. With me looking like an undercover
very European
movie
you
star.
Be in a, you could be in Godfather 7.
Godfather, see, Sicilian clan.
Yeah,
and
like what's
course,
the look? That's pretty cool.
That is Sicilian,
having,
actually.
That's an English shooting hat, cap.
Yes.
Yeah, yeah.
And with somebody in the press said, what's the Devanand hat? So
you should have said that's the Al Pacino in,
it's the Al Pacino
Al Pacino
in Godfather
yeah.
Before he gets hit by the thunderbolt.
With Apollonia.
Apollonia. Apollonia's daughter
wow,
worked in
yes.
my film.
What?
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
Really?
Yeah. So she in Barana, she's the British the girl. That's my connection to Godfather.
Amazing.
See, this we didn't know.
See?
My
yeah.
God.
So anyway, this is Gushtard in Switzerland. And that's Temu's first holiday.
What's your
He's
favorite holiday
pleased.
Destination, Sef? We
probably
know
that.
That?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, ye pata nahi kya pak raha hai yahan pe. What
ah,
what are you
This is training,
trying to
see,
make?
Let's see.
That's Chef Ranjit there. And
oh,
we're training
Ranjit
at the Marriott.
I think this is the first bit of
garlic
being
frying.
Fried.
Yeah. Like
for
garlic
what
being
dish
fried
were you
for
making?
Aglio olio. Spaghetti.
You love spaghetti, don't you?
I like spaghetti aglio olio, yeah.
Yum, okay.
Yeah, and this
Dude,
was,
this film is going to make us very hungry. I'm
this looks so simple and it was just so hard to do because
to
we had to
the
get them
fine.
Fine.
He's such a Chef Ranjeev's amazing. This
yeah.
Marriott kitchen was so nice because
wow.
it's quite close to our home.
And he had to cut. He had a,
Marriott kitchen is amazing because it was close to
yeah,
home.
Yeah, I thought it's, you know.
He had to cut.
I thought we'd go to like Pawai or something. There's a nice kitchen there. I thought, oh no.
It's Marriott. Okay,
close
but
by.
You know,
cutting
we were talking
garlic's
about,
not easy because garlic is this small.
You know, my next question was that because when you said 5:55 was sunset, I realized that the garlic had to be cut in proper sizes. So,
but
kya bhukta?
You're getting a feeling.
Now you're saying,
yeah.
No, no. I mean, obviously, because, so, garlic.
No, but you were a natural with garlic. He was much better at chopping garlic.
Me really easily than onions, you know.
Really?
I mean,
so,
you've got to get
did
your
he
fingers
say
right.
size is not okay and, you know, cut
it was speed, I mean, size fir bhi theek hai, but it was more
noise,
about, it's got to be, you know, the beat of it, na?
Yeah.
So, did you also learn most of this while you were...
I was kind of just acting really cool and watching.
We did lots of stuff, man. We made spaghetti. from scratch, like with atta and egg.
You made
and water.
The spaghetti.
You have to make the spaghetti. Yeah. So yeah. Flour and egg makes it. You know, and then a machine, you put it through like a grinder, and it comes out like spaghetti.
Wow. When was the last time you cooked after the film?
About a month ago or something.
What do you make?
Spaghetti.
From scratch. Okay.
From scratch.
The happy team.
Oh, this is at the party. Oh, you were not here.
You had a party without me?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry.
This is the last day of shoot here. You were in
Bombay?
Yeah.
That's Padma Priya.
Yeah, this is in Bombay. You were not here that day.
So, Padma Priya is there.
Yes.
In Saifu.
You were shooting or you were doing something?
Oh, God knows. I see the truck in the back.
This is like the whole team, huh?
Yeah.
This was the last day of shoot?
Yeah. This was the day after the last day of shoot, yeah.
Listen, did you get sick with all the food and the eating? Or how many kgs did you all put on after this?
I put on some weight, for sure.
Saif?
I did. I had put on weight. But Raja said, you know, don't trust a thin cook. So you got to be a little bit healthy.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah. That was the plan. I said, Nick, when is the last time you could trust a guy who looked like he never ate if he cooked for you?
Sir?
Anna?
No wonder. Yeah, that's true.
So,
you cooks are never like thin.
I'm saying if you're a skinny cook, I'm not eating your food, man.
Actually, both Vikas Khanna and Sanjeev Kapoor are quite thin.
Yeah.
They look good. They're on TV a lot.
But they're like celebrities.
Yeah.
They're celebrities.
Celebrity
they need
chefs,
to like maintain.
The average guy is going to be.
Now that you've said that, now it's going to be in my head, you know.
Yeah.
That I have to actually go and eat that food when the cook is also like.
Yeah, pehle dekh lo. Pehle call the chef out.
Pehle chef.
80 kilo ka theek hai magala
okay guys this is for
oh my
you
God, there's more stuff
yeah. There's a hamper
now this has
this is
a shaving cream as well
to two people with beards
like,
okay
quiet about
thank you so
it,
much yeah this
what is this hand cleanser
like
it's all wonderful
so
thank
sweet.
You
there again ayurvedic products
I don't get
a hand
very impressed
hand
yes.
lotion hand cleanser
is there a shower gel checking all of that out
yeah
You will love it.
I want a shower gel. I like this Kama, you know.
They are
it's a good brand.
Good, yeah. And it's very good for the skin.
Ooh. Thank you.
Also. Yay. Yeah. Okay. So, we come to our last segment, which is called Sangeeta Wants to Know. Because I still want to know a lot of things. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
Saif, the book that you're reading currently.
Jesus, was Akhil Sharma's collection of short stories, A Life of... I can't remember the title, though. Akhil Sharma's short stories.
Short stories. Do you read multiple books at a time?
Sometimes, yeah. Because, I read a lot of non-fiction as well. So, if you're reading the Communist Manifesto, then you can take a break.
Whoa, yes, you need a break then. Yeah. Which is that one book that you recommend to everybody?
The Fountainhead.
Fountainhead. Ayn Rand.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. One uncanny habit of Saif's that you have noticed.
I can't talk about that.
Why? Come on, Raja. Why?
You go blind.
Batao, yaar. He's like ducking. Like, what is it?
No, nothing. I think his kurta pajama and the trouble his management team has every time he comes in out in his kurta pajama.
Whoa!
He's
what?
Like, no, you're going to go. They're going to photograph you. He's like, I'm just wearing my kurta pajama.
Okay. So
I think it looks great in the
computer. Thanks.
Yeah. So this is your kurta.
But I also sleep in that. So,
so you walk out just like that.
Is that the problem?
Not, I have many, multiple outfits that are the same. So, I when I come home and it's hot, I just change into that. I think my wife's a bit bored.
Kurta pajama.
Yeah. So they say don't go out also like that.
Acha.
But I don't care. But we get photographed doing, you know.
You get photographed anyway.
Yeah.
You go to the airport, you get photographed.
But I can't dress for that. Then I'll have lost my something.
You would have lost you.
Also can be probably the most inappropriate. But he has no filter.
Really?
He has no filter.
No filter?
I don't think he does. And that's great. I think that's awesome. I'm tired of people who keep saying the right thing. Like, you know.
Wow, I wish I could say Saif say the most incorrect thing right now.
I think he naturally would.
It
doesn't take like too much.
He doesn't even think about it. Okay, Saif, about Raja.
What?
Uncanny habit, something that he does very often. Of late, he's been cooking a lot, maybe.
There's
some habit, maybe a line he says often or...
While we're shooting?
A particular thing he does.
He repeats the instruction.
Really?
Yeah, very often.
How often?
So I'm like, I don't know, about 15, 20 times or something. I don't know.
Yeah.
Same
so
thing.
So I'm like, I got it.
Yeah, it's often like,
I'm
I got
like,
it.
I got it, I got it. I got it.
Yeah. And then after the take, when I go up and say, you know what?
You forgot it.
You
forgot to do that.
Yeah,
right.
Oh, no. This seems to score in my life. I do that all the time with my director. He tells me, do this. And I'm like, yeah.
Thanks.
I'm like, how many
do you
times?
Think I am? Yeah.
And then he's like, tune to kiya hai nahi.
No, okay. Actually, I think sir figured out.
It mentioned airlift quite a lot.
I did?
Yeah. When I was making airlift, I was like,
I didn't do that. Come on.
Here we go again.
I did that? Yeah, I think you just say like a
cool. And I was making airlift. Yeah. I was like,
I think at some point.
Okay.
Yeah.
I get it.
Yeah. It was always.
He's finally changed his DP to chef. What? It was like airlifted last week.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is not cool, yeah.
Nah,
every time
cool
I message him, I was like, hey,
it's
man.
Not cool.
But I know him, he won't change his DP.
And he's saying not cool and he's okay.
I didn't do that.
Loyal. I didn't do that. Loyal
but,
to the.
But I think that what was interesting was actually kind of Seth very quickly realized when I liked a shot or didn't like a shot.
Oh, yes. Lovely.
So.
Lovely, cut. Otherwise,
then,
we'll keep going.
Oh. Yeah. So you won't ask for
No, I'll keep asking for details.
It's like, you think, you know, I should do one more. I said, no, I'm perfect.
Lovely, great, lovely,
yeah.
Good.
So whenever it's lovely. Or when
so
I say good.
It, lovely.
When I say good. When I say good, he's like, okay, we know we're taking one more take.
Yeah, good's not good.
Super,
not
I like this already. Yeah. Okay, Kareena tells me not to ...
Eat bad food.
Eat bad food, matlab oily.
I was going to say drink too much.
Yeah.
That's not good.
Okay. Seth tells you not to.
It's hardly a...
Is that like a list?
It's not a negative kind of equation. I'm not,
no,
yeah.
In general.
It's not a prohibitive equation.
Not that. I'm not saying it in a negative way.
I think don't keep repeating my instructions.
No, don't talk.
But no. It's
whenever, yeah. whenever we've had late dinners, we both don't remember what happened and everyone keeps telling us.
And the best.
You know what you said to him?
I think they make it up.
I don't think,
convinced they make
it up.
Really? So
for some reason, we can't remember.
Yeah.
You figure out why.
Yeah.
Then we just can't remember what happened.
I'm telling you, those are the best dinners.
Yeah, people come to me and say, you know what you told Seth, and then they go and tell Seth, you know what you told Raja. And actually, I don't think
then you check the next day, sorry. And he's like, no.
So at least it's not like you have some pictures and people are looking at it.
I wish we had pictures.
I don't know if they do.
They must have secretly clicked. Okay. Seth, you're laziest to do what?
Dress up sometimes.
Yeah.
Dress up, yeah. I mean, I can, climate wise, you know, if it's winter, I love dressing up.
Hmm.
But if it's hot, I'm lazy to dress up.
Okay. What about you, Raja? Are you lazy?
No, you get up really, you're not lazy.
No, I'm not lazy.
Yeah, because
but
I also no. South Indian wake up very early.
Like that, yeah, I'm one of those people who don't sleep too much.
You don't sleep too much.
I don't sleep too much.
Oh, okay. Then I'm lazy to wake up.
Yeah, I'm one of those.
Generally.
Yeah? So
I mean,
you can
I like
sleep continuous for how many hours?
12.
Really?
Whoa.
11. Yeah, I can do 10 to 10.
Wow.
So you sleep even for Raja.
Yeah, that's probably what. Because for me, it's
like I don't sleep at all.
But that's very rare. That's when I'm catching up on my sleep.
Huh.
Like
so
if I haven't slept a lot, if I really, then one day I can do like a 12 hour. Otherwise, 7 hours I sleep.
That's good enough. That's very good, actually.
Sleep is...
You're just not lazy.
I'm not lazy about that, but I'm lazy about actually just dressing up. I pick the top, whatever's on top of my list. That's it, yeah. So oftentimes people have problems.
Oh my God, okay. Most precious thing
I wish we should live, some of us should push it. We should live in a society that looks within and not what you're wearing and all these. All that. Everyone shoots you and then puts it up and then someone makes
but that's
a
how it is,
fashion
no?
comment.
You
airport look. If I ever get an airport look, just come and slap me.
Please tell me you don't have airport
look. I don't. But we're under pressure to have.
Yeah? So have you started having your airport
No, never.
Looks?
My Thank airport God. Looks like a non-look. It's like, you know.
It's comfortable. I think that's your airport look and that's what it should be.
Yeah.
Okay. Most precious thing you own, Seth?
Most precious thing
I own? Yeah, very close to your heart.
Oh. Family members you don't really own.
No, you can't own them.
You can't say them.
My wife, I own. It's probably that Gibson Les Paul guitar I have, which I think is really nice. Yeah. Or an amplifier, or a record player, or...
Wow, there's like
too
many things. I like it.
Yeah, maybe some electronic thing or a watch or something. I mean, I'm equally... fakir-like, unattached, but also equally materialistic.
So that's your guitar, huh?
Yeah, I'd say guitar, my guitar.
Amazing. What about you, Raja?
My books.
Your books?
Hey, I want to say books as well. Some first editions even. Really
wow,
nice
tell
books,
me, yeah. Name some.
Like Edgar Allan Poe's first edition on Some stories is written. Jungle Book, I have the first edition. I have Sherlock Holmes, first edition. Paradise Lost, Coleridge, first. I have about 20.
This is like a paradise. This
really?
He's got an
like that?
He's got an incredible
library. This is amazing.
Library. He's got an incredible library.
So how many books do you own, Seth?
I don't know. Most of them, I don't know. But like, well, the walls full. I haven't
read
them
all. Books.
But I mean, like actually, the feeling. I love books.
When we first met, that's when I said, okay, we're going to get along.
Yeah, yeah.
Because of books.
I went to meet him in Pataudi. And we went to the library.
Yeah.
And I just walked inside there. It's the most beautiful library.
It's in the smell of books.
And it's
so
just,
amazing.
It's an old English kind of like a lounge library kind of thing. And it's wonderful. You know, you feel like even if there's no cigar, you kind of feel the cigar and the smoky whiskey and the
so
and the thing.
Cool.
It's like beautiful.
Okay, last question. What is your advice to Sara? Considering now she is obviously entering Bollywood, what would you want to tell her?
To, you know, focus on the art and be an interesting actor. And look within and just be honest and enjoy
it. Looks also.
No, that's don't get caught up with these frills. The idea is to be an actor and to live like that. You know, don't follow the rules. Don't buy the hype, and just kind of keep it pure. Travel, make your own rules, but be pure to your job. Work on your acting.
Wow, that's Saif Ali Khan, and we love him, don't we? Here.
My God, what is going on?
We're getting a lot of presents.
This is for you, Seth.
Ooh, thank you.
This
is great. You
and
bring people on the show.
You,
thank you. Oh, this is amazing.
Dude, this is a
we
Bluetooth
get to come
speaker.
Here and you get a Bluetooth.
Please, I would love to chat with you more.
Zabronics.
Wonderful.
Yeah, I hope you like
that
it.
That is wonderful. Thank you so much.
The speakers.
Thank you very much.
And
she's got another couple of bags. There. Right.
Okay, so this is our good luck to you and the team.
My God, you guys are too nice.
Can I get someone to carry this? What is this now?
There are lots of things, so yeah.
Really?
Wow. That's a bag, so this is for you.
Thank you so much.
And
wow.
We started
like,
the show saying that this is our 50th episode.
Yes.
And we have organized a cake, and we would love it if you celebrated with us.
We would love
so
to.
So let's get the cake.
We would love to.
50 episodes.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Of season 2.
Wonderful.
Wow.
Let's got it.
Should we
go for it, guys.
Can we move?
Yay.
So, yes.
Yeah, you can feed her something.
And I'm not the best at doing this, but
that's brilliantly done.
You cannot say this after you made a movie.
That's pretty good. I still got it on the knife.
Thank you.
Yeah, you did. It's great.
Yeah,
right?
I mean it didn't fall, so great.
Small piece.
Listen, this cake also is for all those people who are watching us on Yaar Mera Superstar season 2. Thank you. Aaj humne hamara 50th episode mana with Seth and Raja. Thank you so much for being on the show. All the best for Chef.
Thank you so much.
And I know they're going to make us very hungry, but we're also hungry for great films that you guys are a part of.
This one took me by surprise.
Thank you. I wondered.
Yeah, I thought it was.
He's telling me about the photo. Of course, next week we meet again on Yaar Mera Superstar with me, Sangeeta. Zoom, turn on.